So let us start. So we'll be starting with a new topic called conic sections. Right? So here actually conic sections meaning the section of a cone. So that means if you take one particular cone, let us say there is one particular cone like this. Now this is the shape of the cone, right? On this cone actually, if you cut at different locations, you are going to get different shapes. So one shape is, suppose actually if you cut like this, then actually this portion, if you take it, if you expand it like this, then actually it is going to form a shape like this, right? So this shape actually is called as the parabola. So out of this cone actually, if you cut at one corner, if you take this part out, and this is going to have a shape like this. And then actually, if you try to cut at this particular location, then actually it is still be of this particular shape only, but it is an expanded form like this. So this is how it is going to be. Now this expanded form, if you notice, this is still be a parabola, but actually a bigger parabola, or actually outside, or actually from the middle, actually, if you notice, it's a bigger than that particular size. So this parabola is called as the high parabola. And then if you cut exactly at this particular point, where this is going to be of circle. So if you cut at this particular location, if you look at from the top side, the shape what you are going to get at this particular location is of the shape, it is going to be a circle. So it's a parabola, this is a high parabola, this is a circle. Now actually, if I cut slantly like this, so if I slantly cut this, now if I look at from this side, the shape what I can see here, it is, this is of this particular shape, and this shape actually is called as ellipse. So this is the ellipse. Now see this actually, out of one cone, if you cut at different locations, you are going to get different equations or different shapes. All these shapes, that is the high parabola, ellipse, circle, all these shapes are called as the conic sections. These are the conic sections because all the shapes can be extracted. Can be extracted from a cone. Hence, these shapes are called as conic sections. So these shapes are called as the conic sections. Now actually, why do we need to study all these shapes together is, this equation of this particular shapes is always in the form of, so the shapes are actually usually of this particular formula, ax square plus bx square plus 2hxy plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Now this is the generalized equation for all the conic sections. So for all the conic sections actually, this is the generalized equation. So depending upon the values of a, b, c, h and g, f, c. So here actually a, b, c and h, g, f, all these values actually will decide which shape it has to be. So the same equation, depending upon the values of a, b, c and h and g and f, so these values actually will give different shapes. It may be a parabolic shape, or maybe an ellipse shape, or maybe a circular shape, or it may be a hyperbola shape. So in all the cases actually, so this is the generalized equation. Now out of this, we will be studying one by one. Now the studying of this conic sections itself actually, it forms more than 60% of your syllabus in 2B. So 60% syllabus in 2B. So second year B, mathematics, there actually out of the entire syllabus, 60% is specific to the study of conic sections, remaining 40% is the calculus. So these are the only two topics we have out of the entire 2B mathematics, right? Now out of this actually, we'll be solving one by one. Now here, for all the conic sections actually, the equations are actually derived from a single principle. The single principle actually, so what it says is, suppose actually, if there is a fixed point, let us say I take one particular coordinate axis like this. So this is the x-axis and this is y-axis. Now the x-axis and y-axis, now I take one fixed point at this particular location. This is a fixed point. And then actually I take one fixed line. So let us say this is one particular fixed line. Now here actually this is one point which we call as the focus. And this is another point called as the directrix. So this line is called as the directrix. And this point is called as the focus point. Now you are trying to identify all the points which satisfies the condition that if I randomly consider one particular point here, let us say I calculate this distance and then actually I calculate this distance and then actually I am trying to identify all such points which will have the same distance as that of this one. So if this is S and this is P and this is M, then actually this point, if I try to calculate the distance SP and if that is exactly equal to the PM distance, now I will be tracing all such points actually which will have the same distance from this point to this point and this point to this straight line. So if I try to draw, suppose actually I take one more point here. See this, now I try to identify one more point here. Now here actually this is the point distance and then actually this is the distance to the straight line. Now this distance, so I call this as M1 and this as M2, and I take one more point here and then I try to calculate distance and then actually I calculate this distance M2. Now this is P1, this is P2, this is P3. Now in all the cases actually SP1 is equal to P1 M1 and SP2 is equal to P2 M2, SP3 is equal to P3 M3. Now if I take actually one more point here, let us say, now this distance I call this as P4 and then this distance I call this as M4. So even then also SP4 is equal to P4 M4. Now all these kind of cases, if you notice, it is trying to maintain a rule that it is having the equal distance from this fixed point to the variable point here and from this variable point to this fixed line. So as long as these distances are same, you are trying to trace all such kind of points, it is going to give one particular shape. This shape is called as the parabola. So R, this rule actually in general, SP by PM is equal to 1. Now this rule says that it is going to be of parabola. So this is a parabola.